They're coming to get you, Barbara.
Welcome to Rewind Horror, your one-stop shop for all your horror needs. Today we're going to be looking at zombie films, flesh-eating demons from hell. We all love them, or do we? Well, it turns out a lot of people are pretty tired of them. With the likes of Shaun of the Dead, the Resident Evil films, and of course The Walking Dead being a dominating force in television for the past 10 years, spawning spin-off shows and inspiring a resurgence in the genre on the big screen, zombies have become somewhat tiresome for many. However, there are many modern gems, so today we're going to look at some more modern zombie movies that I think are well worth your time. So of course, zombies as we know them in popular culture started with George Romero's Night of the Living Dead in 1968, and if you haven't seen his films, I really do recommend them, my favourite being Dawn of the Dead, but honestly all those films are really well worth your time if that is a bit of a blind spot for you. So the first movie on our list is the 2007 Spanish found footage movie Wreck, which is probably the scariest film on our list. The film centres on a TV reporter and her cameraman following a firefighter team for the night, leading to a visit to an apartment building in Barcelona, which is unknowingly ground zero for a zombie virus. It was excellently remade as Quarantine, with only a few minor changes for the English language audience, but I would still really encourage you to watch the original. The 2009 sequel, Wreck 2, is really, really good and ties in really well with the original. There is a third and fourth film. The third one is pretty good, but I'm not a huge fan. I haven't seen the fourth one yet, but apparently it does improve on the third one a bit. Pontypool from 2008 is a low-budget zombie film based on the book Pontypool Changes Everything, written by Tony Burgess. It tells the story of Grant Mazzi, played by Stephen McCarthy, a small-town radio host who, along with his fellow radio techs, begin to learn that all is not well in the town of Pontypool, where they broadcast. While probably my least favourite on this list, it's the most unique. On the face of things, it isn't that much different from many other low-budget zombie flicks, but it does a fantastic job of painting a picture of the outside world falling apart without needing to show it. Through the host's interactions with incoming calls, it starts to paint a picture of the outside world falling apart. The main difference with this film is actually the virus is totally different. It's not spread through bites like traditional zombie films, it's actually spread through language and words. It's hard to really explain without you just seeing the film, and I don't really want to spoil what that means. So if that intrigues you, I really highly recommend you just watch the film. It's truly a different take on the zombie genre.
Mrs. French's cat is missing. The signs are posted all over town. Have you seen Honey? We've all seen the posters, but nobody has seen Honey the cat. Nobody. Until last Thursday morning, when Miss Colette Piscine swerved her car to miss.
So the next film is 2012's The Battery. This is the directorial debut from Jeremy Gardner, who also stars in the film. It follows two baseball players as they travel across New England looking for survivors. This is a slow burn film with not a lot of zombie action again. It's another low budget film. While I do wish they did more with their budget and showed us a little bit more, this really is a character study of two friends trying to come to terms with the new normal as they survive. The Girl with All the Gifts from 2016. Now this is what happens when respect is given to the source material and a big Hollywood budget is put behind it. This is one of my favorite books, and it's one of my favorite zombie films also. We follow Melanie, seemingly a normal child held by scientists with other children. However, all the children are actually hungries, aka flesh-eating zombies. But they have retained intelligence, social skills to some degree, So long as they can't smell human pheromones and aren't triggered to attack, they seem totally normal. This one hits hard on the emotions and is really well acted and beautifully shot. This is not your throwaway sort of popcorn film, and it is just a great film, and I highly recommend the book.
I am producing a vaccine, and she is the main ingredient.
What am I?
Hope.
That's what you are.
2016's Train to Busan is one of the most intense films ever. It's very likely that if you haven't seen it already, you've heard of it. It really, truly is ball-clenchingly tense. And there is a reason everyone has gone crazy over this film in the last 4 years. The film follows the father and daughter as they travel to the city of Busan via train. Unknown to the occupants, a massive outbreak of a zombie virus has taken hold of the country and is devastating everything. What follows is a story of parental love, self-preservation, and class warfare. Brutal and emotional, this is easily one of my favourite films in horror and all cinema. This is a must-see for horror fans. The next film is another horror from Asia. This is Japan's One Cut of the Dead from 2017. Overlooked by some due to its low budget and odd opening scenes, you'll find many accounts online of people abandoning this film before the crucial moment it truly makes sense, complaining the film didn't live up to what they had heard. It's hard to explain the genius of One Cut of the Dead without spoiling the film completely. The first 37 minutes of the film without context are a little hard to watch at times. The rest of the film serves to explain what you just watched, and it makes it oh so worth the watch. This is a must-see, particularly if you're interested in filmmaking and acting, as you'll have an extra level of appreciation there. It's really hard to explain much more without spoiling what the film truly is, so just trust me and watch it. Our next film is 2019's Little Monsters. This is truly a delightful film, and it's a great film to watch if you're with someone who is not really a big horror fan, as it's really a heartfelt film. Lupita Nyong'o is fabulous as a kindergarten teacher desperately trying to keep her class alive during a zombie outbreak while on a school trip to a petting zoo. With genuinely sweet on-screen chemistry between the children and the main characters, contrasted by the absurdity of violence and horror of a regular zombie film, this will easily put a smile on your face. While there have been many other comedy horrors, this is actually one of the more like joyful and delightful films out there. So I think this is a really good feel-good movie to put on if you're not feeling great.
Next stop, Pleasant Valley.
Having a super fun time on our trip.
I want you all in a line in front of me and away we go.
Why are we stopping?
There must be something in the way.
What is it, Miss Caroline?
No! Oh, God! Stop the tractor!
Are you okay?
Yes!
So our final movie today is the 2019 film Blood Quantum. Blood Quantum is a Canadian horror film written and directed by Jeff Barnaby, which follows the reaction of a First Nation preserve who, because of their Indigenous heritage, are immune to a zombie virus. This is truly a great zombie movie and has biting social commentary on racism and social divide within the First Nation people living in Canada and America, who both star and made the movie. So I highly recommend this film. I do recommend you do some reading on the phrase blood quantum. As a Brit, we don't get any history lessons in school on Indigenous people of North America and Canada. So I wasn't aware of any of the history there. I'm going to leave a link below to a video which I found really helpful. But obviously there's plenty of articles and things online which you can find.
The bigger problem than the dead walking around townies, the live breathing ones. They're coming across in almost the same numbers. Some people in Red Crow don't like it. but we gotta do right by survivors.
So that's it for this video. Thank you very much for watching. If you did enjoy, please feel free to drop a like and subscribe and all that good stuff. I'd like you to comment down below what your favorite zombie movie is. I'd love to know. I'm always looking for good suggestions. Please also comment if you watched any of the movies that I suggested today. I'd love to hear what you guys think of it. I'm always looking for new stuff. And I'm always watching new stuff. You can see what I'm watching over on Instagram and Twitter at Rewind Horror. I'll leave some links and things down in the description below. But for now, I'm just going to say goodbye and I'll see you next time. Bye.
How's that for a slice of fried gold?
Yeah, boy!